today we will talk about molecularity. See, in the previous one we have discussed order many times in board exam. The difference between order and molecularity is asked. Okay, so first we will talk about molecularity and then the differences we will discuss. Now, what is molecularity defined as? It is defined as the number of atoms, ions or molecules that are taking part in a reaction which forms a product. Now, which are taking part in the reaction means, if it is a simple reaction, then as many atoms, ions, molecules are represented in the equation, that is the molecularity. Got it? As, like for example, first one, O2F2 forming O2 plus F2. One molecule is shown, it is called as unimolecular. So based upon what is the molecularity, you can we can term the reaction as a unimolecular reaction. If the molecularity is 2, bimolecular reaction. If it is 3, termolecular reaction, and so on. This is applicable only for simple reactions. Simple reaction means, as given in the balanced equation, whatever is the coefficient, that is the molecularity. Like if you remember, in order also we have discussed, order is never determined from the balanced equation. It is always determined from the experimental. As per the experiment, what we get, that we decide. We will come to the next one. If it is a complex reaction, then, if it is a complex reaction, we have to see the mechanism. Mechanism is in how many steps the reaction is taking place. For example, see, for a complex reaction, we say the molecularity depends upon the mechanism, not as many reactants are specified. The slowest step is the rate determining step. I am taking example of N2O5 decomposition. The equation is this. It appears as if 2 molecularity is there, but the molecularity is 1. How? This is the mechanism. The first step, N2O5 forms NO2 plus NO3. In the second step, N2O5 again reacts with one of the intermediate NO3 and it forms NO2 plus O2. If I combine the two reactions, I will be cancelling NO3. I will get that main equation again. Out of the two reactions, the first is slow and the second is fast. Whichever is the slowest step, that is the rate determining step. Now, rate determining step means the rate law will be written taking into consideration only the slowest step. So, I will write the rate law as dx by dt, rate of reaction, is equal to k, rate constant, into concentration of N2O5. Though it was 2, we will write it as 1. Because as per the mechanism, we got it as 1. Let us take very simple example to understand molecularity. Suppose there is a cycle factory, and in that factory there are various units manufacturing paddle, handle, the rim. So in a day, how many cycles will be assembled, that depends upon the least number given by one particular unit. For example, if there are 50 handles, okay, 100 paddles, and you are getting 50 rims, 50 means pair I am talking about, then in a day 50 complete cycles will be ready. That depends upon the least number which is coming up every day. So always we say the slowest step is the rate determining step. Now, like we discussed for order, we are saying here also, molecularity cannot be zero or fraction, but order can be. One difference. The second difference, you can write the definition only. Okay, definition will be one difference. Second will be order can be zero, can be fractional, molecularity cannot be. Third difference you will write, order is determined experimentally, whereas this is determined by mechanism. If it is a complex reaction, then the mechanism decides the molecularity. If it is a simple reaction, then whatever is the number of the reactants is the molecularity. So I have given both examples, simple and complex. Clear? So three main differences, definition, this part, and how you are determining. Order is always experimental basis. This is depending upon whether it is simple or complex, whether directly from the reaction or from the mechanism. So I discuss one numerical also based on order. What type of questions are asked in board exam? 1-1 mark questions. A reaction is second order with respect to the reactant. They are asking how is dx by dt means rate of reaction affected if the concentration of R is reduced to half. Depending upon what is given in the question, first we write the rate law. It is second order with respect to the reactant, so we will write dx by dt is equal to k R to the power 2. Now they are saying if the rate law, if the concentration of R is reduced to half, means it is now R by 2. If I do this R by 2 square, it will become R square by 4. That means 1/4 of the first one. So what is the effect of the on the rate of reaction? If the concentration is halved, it will be 1 by 4. It can be anything asked. If you double concentration of R, if you make it 1 by 4, if you make it 4 times, make it 3 times, what is the effect on the rate of the reaction? So variety of questions can be framed from this part.